Paw Paw's Pickles, Pecan Corner. Crispy pickles. Today, I'm going to make Paw Paw's Pickles. And it's going to be a test batch because I've never ever water bathed anything at a specific temperature. So, we'll see. They look delicious. I got the recipe from Pecan Corner. Go visit her. She's fabulous. She's great. Okay, tell her Aunt Duddie sent you. So here's what it is. The Paw Paw's Pickle brine consists of 2 cups of white vinegar, 10 cups of filtered water. I used my Pro Pure. I always use that for anything we consume. And 1 1/4 cups of canning salt. So I put it in the jug. I shook it up. And I'm just going to let it sit until it dissolves. So Hungry Hubby and his best bud had a gig over the weekend. And it was at a park far, far away. And they got thunderstormed to death. Anyway, there was a little old lady walking around handing out cucumbers. So he got 2 so I could try this recipe. Isn't that nice? Here's the other ingredients you're going to need for about 1 quart of pickles. For each quart, you're going to use 2 garlics, 2 chilies, and grape leaves. Grape leaves. Anyway, these grape leaves we couldn't find in any store. I think that's why I ended up with so many groceries, because everywhere he went to find me grape leaves was having a sale on something. Anyway, he ordered them from Amazon, so thank you, Hungry Hubby. He got way more than I need. I need 2 per quart. I think I'm only going to get 1 quart. Alright, so that's it. You need the brine, you need the pickles. Don't use those waxy grocery store ones, they're disgusting. You need the chili pods, you need the grape leaves, you need the garlic. Alright, if anyone knows what to do with leftover grape leaves, let me know. I don't want to waste them. And if we don't really like the pickles, I don't know. What else can I use them for? Besides stuffed grape leaves, which I don't like. Anyway, what do I do with the leftovers until I'm ready to make more pickles? Oh yeah, he got baby dill because you know what? There's no dill anywhere. Not even the farmer's market. So this thing was smooshed down on top of the grape leaves. Hungry had to fish it out for me. Kept them submerged. That's a pretty good deal. Alright, so I need 2. Let's see if I can get them out without... Nope, I can't. Alright, let me do this delicately. These grape leaves are packed so tight, they're destroyed on the way out. Aww. Anyway, I'll save those for another... thing. And here's half the jar that came out. So what they've done is they've just rolled leaf on leaf. So yeah, I guess you'll have to waste a few to get a few. I'll try and make them pretty. This is what they look like, at least the ones I didn't mutilate trying to get them out of the jar. So I need 2 per quart. I'd be pretty mad if I had to get these and the whole jar was like this. You couldn't stuff them. Anyway, these are good for the pickles, I guess. Scrub your cucumbers. This is the stem end. This is the blossom end. Cut about 1/16 to 1/8 or even 1/4 of an inch off the blossom end because it will make your pickles soggy if you don't. Crunchy. Then you just want to cut them in spears. Good. When you're filling your jars, you can put your grape leaf in as best as you can. Lay it on its side. And go ahead and... Oh! They're too big. Okay, I'm going to have to cut a little bit more off. They come up to the 1/2 inch mark. Maybe that's a little too big. We'll see. These pickles are too seedy. They look pretty though. Anyway, don't buy such great big old pickles that somebody was giving away at the park. So I poured the brine in. Gave it what I think might be too much head space. It wants a half inch, but I'm jiggling the jar so the bubbles come up. So I'll top it off. Yeah, a little bit more. Half inch is right here. 1 inch would be the bottom of the threads. Half inch, the middle of the threads. Ooh, the breeze is nice. Time to make the pickles. So you can just store your Paw Paw's pickle brine in the vinegar jug. I save vinegar jugs. They always come in handy for something. Ooh, that took a lot of water. I guess I'll have to can something else so as not to waste it. Alright, it's 120 degrees and we want to go between 180 and 185. If it goes under 180, you have to start your time all over again. And if it goes over 185, you might end up with a sooner than you think sogginess. Okay, so it's 120. We're going to go to here, 180. How did I get that instant read thermometer in there? I used my hang it on the range hood magnets for my recipes. Used two of them and poked this thing through the hole like so. And it's in the water, not touching the sides or the cans. And I think at 180 to 185 for 30 minutes, but I'll double check. I only read it 25 times. I watched the video 16 times. Even though we have soft water here in Duddieville, I'm going to throw in a little vinegar to keep the jars nice and clean and no minerals. Why? I don't know. I always follow the rules. Mostly. Almost 140. This feels weird not having a lid on it with rapidly boiling water. It does, but I'm going to do it. They're ready to eat tomorrow, so we'll do the wonky looking jar with the chopped up ends of the cucumber that didn't fit in the jar. We'll eat that one for a taste tester and save the other ones for a cookout. What's a cookout? I don't know. Out here they call them potlucks, but back east are cookouts. Your friends come over, you grill, you barbecue. Okay, it's over 140, but it's pretty warm out here, and I'm sitting right by that burner. At least there's a breeze. Hubby hurt his neck, so he can't carry the air conditioner back to the bedroom. That really helped the last heat wave we had. But he can't do it, so oh well, we'll just suffocate. It's not that humid here, not at all. Okay, so drink your sun tea, play a game on your video thingy, get ready to poke your timer for 30 minutes, and it'll be fun. 170. So this is 30 minutes to get up to temperature on this little burner, but this one doesn't get as hot as the camp stove. 1 hour and 20 minutes, and I am stalled at 170. Ooh, I hope they're good. Okay, I put the lid on, and now I'm 180, too high. Okay, I'll lower the heat, take the lid off. Halfway there, I had to turn the canner off because even on the lowest possible flame, it was going up to 190. So it's a good thing we're going to eat these in the next couple weeks, otherwise they might be mushy. Anyway, I've turned it off and then I just lit it again. And hopefully I'm not going to drop below 180. 15 minutes to go. 184. 7 more minutes. Ooh, it's down to 180. I just turned the burner back on. About 30 seconds to go, so I'm going to put them on a towel-covered board on my little table so that they can be a little out of the draft, and I'll wait a few minutes to bring them in the house. I hope that they're crispy because they've been in this canner forever. I'll let you know when I take them out how many minutes they're in. But, you know, during the heating up process and the 30-minute cook process, turn that off. They have been in here for a real long time. They look pretty. We shall see. They were in the canner exactly 2 hours. Okay, that's a long time. I don't know. We'll try a jar tomorrow. We'll try this one because it's got all chunky pieces in it. Anyway, that's that.